the stigmas in most species of Nymphaeaceae, the stigma, which is the female organ, actually gets warm by 3 to 6 degrees centigrade and emits a smell, a pheromone. And the pheromone attracts the insects. And the insects... Shush what?
The phone.
But the phone's interrupting me, not me, the phone.
Yes, but...
Do you want me to stop?
I heard through the body odor from others, we realize if we are genetically matching or not. And unfortunately, the way nature works is of odor rather than perfume, you know. So the way it is, I'm sorry, I can't change it. So I smell and I like to smell people as well. If I smell you in the street, don't be offended.
I went to an animal rescue charity in a very deprived part of northwest London. And I took one look at her, and something happened. It was one look, absolutely one look.
I didn't really like him, actually, to be honest, at the beginning, because I thought it was a bit of a sort of know-it-all.
Oh, yeah.
But the way he ate a sandwich. that was it, really. And you could see his stomach. So, yeah, that's why I quite liked him, first of all.
You've got to be confident and optimistic. If you're pessimistic and always on the back foot, I don't think you'd get anywhere. So, you know, a bit of the old cockiness, you know, I think they all like a bit of that.
I am sexy all the time. Do you know what I mean?
Well, which part of you?
Oh,
exactly.
All of me, of course. You know, that's... So I feel like that when I get out in the mornings, you know, I feel very sexy. Most of the times you're not there, but there you are. You know, can't help that, can he? Yeah. Do you feel sexy?
No, totally.
Well, it is early, isn't it?
Yeah, sure. Of course I'm sexy. I can use my voice. I can tell you I love you. I can whisper this on your ear 100 million times and you will scream for more, more and more. I have a great smile, which you will never find anywhere else in this world.
It sounds corny now, but he used to always get the same chat line as you. You know what it is? You know the best part of your body? It's a bit in between the top of your head and the bottom of your feet. All of you. I say, you're lovely. I said, I've seen some lovely lasses in my time, but I said, but you must have been right ahead of the queue in the audition with the good looks. But when I was seeing all these things, I had my fingers crossed.
Biggest turn on for me. Lovely bottoms. They must have a nice bottom. I don't know what it is. I'm not too bothered about the front bit, but the bottom bit I do quite like.
I'd never worried about size or shape or thing. I've lived with mongrels for half my life. And suddenly here was I, head over heels, in love or what?
It's lovely being in love. It makes you all twinkly and it makes you all happy. And sometimes I can't think straight, do you know what I mean? Because I'm thinking of him. Ooh.
If you're looking for a disco dancing spring rabbit, then you would find me a bit boring. But if you are the kind of person who likes to sit around and moan a lot, then you could say I'm a very good companion.
No, actually, he's not too bad. He's not that unsavoury a person. I think he's all right.
Thank you.
Because I'm really intolerant.
I'm not that unsavoury a person.
The thing is with you, your mother did everything for you. And then when you come up to me, you're ready bloody useless.
Obey, that's what the vicar
no,
said.
No, I didn't. When we got married, I did not obey.
Obey.
No, I didn't obey.
Obey?
No.
I have lots of trapped air that has to get out somehow. And that's really bad when you're sleeping with someone. And methane gas is lighter than air, so you end up on the ceiling. And so that's why I choose not to sleep with anybody, and that's why I don't have a partner for a long time. It's all not my fault, it's the methane gas fault.
I've got about, wait, let me count. 19 boys fancy me, but I don't fancy them. I actually fancy Roo and he fancies me because you're pretty, that's why. I'm really gonna get in for that.
I used to be very romantic when I was younger. I think everybody who's younger is very romantic, you know? Fall in love, thinking about the partner, doing different things to them in your head.
Romantic? No, not really.
Yeah, you no, are. No. You are. Really
nonsense. No. I don't think so.
I think you are. You're very thoughtful. You are.
You never said that before.
Oh, I'm not on tape then, am I?
Yeah, no, I'm a little bit romantic. I like to, I like to lavish gifts upon my my wife, and and I do like to treat her to things that I know that she likes.
Trip down Tesco's.
Yeah, she loves all that stuff.
What about me?
Are you romantic?
You tell me.
No, you're not.
Aren't I?
No.
I am.
No, you're not.
You're just saying it now.
No, you're not. I'm not.
I am actually.
I do believe in love at first sight, but I'm not saying it does anyone any good. What happens after that? That's as much as I'm saying.
No, we've got three, you see, but there's one I can never remember a name. She does a lot of riding. I'm trying to think of a flipping name now. What's she called? Well, let's just call her Rosie for today. Yeah, Rosie. Good old Rosie.
Oh! I've pulled a muscle.